Okay, please join me in welcome Khun Wilai Phorn to be Lamphan Pho from PwC Thailand. Okay.
Hello, good afternoon everyone. It's good to be here. Thank you Dr. Kathy for the introduction and Dr. Jay as well. Your last slide is nicely to my session. So my name is Wilai Phorn. I am a partner from PricewaterhouseCoopers Consulting. I'm from PwC, but I'm not an accountant or an auditor, a technology person. And I've been in the industry for over 25 years now. So good to be here and speak about FinTech, which is quite popular these days. So who here hasn't heard of the term FinTech before? No, right? Obviously, like, you haven't heard of this term. It's been very popular in the media coverage, and FinTech has been driving dramatic changes to the financial service sector. So, good to be able to talk about it today. So, given the time, I believe I have about 25 minutes. So, I wanted to touch on four things. One, what is FinTech really? Right, so let's have a look today. And second, this is from PwC survey. So, we have done an annual survey on FinTech, and the result of recent survey has just come out. So, I wanted to share with you some of the highlights. And third, which is quite important, FinTech ecosystem. FinTech is such a broad term, so let's have a look at within FinTech, what are the key focus areas? And this FinTech ecosystem changes every day. So if you're interested, you have to actually keep searching and keep yourself up to date. Because technology moves so fast these days. So that's why there are new FinTech, there are old FinTech who don't survive. I do recommend if you're interested in the topic, do check into FinTech ecosystem, understand how much it has evolved. The last thing, what you can do today, right, how would you adjust? And this, actually, this is a slide that I speak to most of my clients as well. As an entrepreneur, business owner, financial industry, or for each of you as an individual person, what you have to change, be able to stay up here in the world. So quick one, what is FinTech? Oops, sorry. So FinTech is the convergence of financial services and technology. FinTech is a company, usually a startup, that leverage emerging technology or advancement of technology to innovate financial services. FinTech has been changing the way that we do transactions, the way that you invest, the way that you do payment, deposit, apply for a loan, or even check credit rate that you wouldn't believe it. So FinTech is actually a small company, but some have become very large and compete directly with financial institutions. So over the past, I believe in Thailand, over the past 24 months, we have seen a number of FinTech in Thailand increasing exponentially. And we have now an organization called Thailand FinTech, a proper association led by Bhutan for the government. We actually see the popularity and see that FinTech can really help drive changes financial services in Thailand and help with the financial inclusion as well. So he himself has funded and actually formed his organization. Help promote FinTech in Thailand and encourage people like yourself or interested to actually try to explore this one. So what has been driving FinTech? How come FinTech have become so popular? So five factors. One is innovation. Because technology only gets better and better every day, right? So whoever knows how to leverage this in the business will win. So FinTech is a group of financial technology companies that are focusing on using technology to improve the quality of financial services. So to pick up one idea, use the advanced technology like P2P, blockchain, Bitcoin to improve the quality of financial services. So this has been the key driving force. And it actually helped change financial service model as well. I have a few examples on my latest slide on what are the top FinTechs that have been very successful in the market. The second one is funding. FinTech is a small company, right? It won't survive without money. So over the past 24 months, we have seen, especially in Thailand, a lot of investment, a lot of funding from the government, from regulator, from financial institute, from venture capital, investing heavily into FinTech. And that helped keep FinTech alive. And it can use the money to actually stay afloat and be able to continue with the innovation and help launch new services. Big financial services like banking, look at the news, right? The Sigon Bank, Siam Commercial Bank, and many other banks are investing heavily in FinTech with the funding that they provide. And the third factor is market penetration. I think this link might be to your slide as well. if you look at the overall population in Thailand, there are still a large percentage of people who do not have access to good quality banking services because they're not interested. For back there, they're the segment that really make money or make profit. So banks actually ignore them. And this has become an opportunity for small companies like FinTech that they, so those guys who still have access to good quality banking services through FinTech. You don't have to go to the bank. Like, if you want to apply for a loan, a quick loan, a short loan, and you don't have good credit rating, you still can get money by going to FinTech. And this has opened up a new opportunity, a huge new segment, which actually become, and back then, when they start to see the FinTech actually make some money from this one, back then get interested and say, hey, let's have a look, right? Because they don't want to ignore this, this segment. So FinTech has helped with market penetration. And the fourth one, product life cycle. You're a bank, big financial institutes, insurance or banking, to launch any new product or new service, it will take months. Let's say you are an insurance company, to launch a new policy, internally the whole process takes sometimes 4 to 6 months. And then there's an external process, you need to get OIC approval. OIC is a regulator that regulates insurance company. So the whole process will take a year, right? But FinTech, given the size, has the ability to actually turn ideas into actions and then introduce service pretty quickly. So from years, it could reduce to weeks. And that's pretty effective and attractive to people like us when we get to access new services very quickly. You don't have to wait for banks or insurance for weeks a day. So this product lifecycle time to market has reduced significantly because of FinTech. And back when you start to see the FinTech, have the ability to launch new service quickly, they actually look at themselves and say, how come I'm very slow? A big financial institute, but it takes me forever. So they're adjusting the services themselves and process internally to maybe actually launch service new quicker. And the last one, customer impact. Customer like you and I, we actually like to have good quality banking service with cheap fee. So FinTech actually, I'm not sure if any of you have used FinTech service before, like peer-to-peer, or apply for a loan, actually quite effective, very quick. So we actually feel that we have good experiences with FinTech, and we didn't expect the bank to be able to provide the same quality of services as well. So these are the five factors that drive for, and we will continue to see the big growth in the number of FinTech companies in Thailand. The next thing I want to mention, and you see these logos, I'm sure most of you, or all of you, are customers of these companies, Apple, Uber, who hasn't used Uber before. You know, like in this generation. So Apple, Uber, and what is this? Amazon, right? So we have a company. They are technology companies, right? So what Apple does is Apple is very well known for anywhere, anytime services. You want to buy music, movie, you can just go to Apple anytime you want to, right? Or Uber is an on-demand. You don't need a car, who needs a car these days, right? You need a taxi, you just pick up the mobile phone, just say, click that I'm here, pick me up, and from the university, you can go to Silo or Sierra Square. You don't need a car anymore, on demand, anytime, anywhere. And the third thing is Amazon, right? Amazon is well known to have a very good analytics. It can actually predict what you want to buy next. If you, I'm not sure if you have bought a book from Amazon before, I certainly know the customer. If you bought a book from Amazon, it would then recommend you that, given your profile, you look at our database, people like who have similar profile also bought this book. So we suggest you should look into this one as well. So that's a very good analytic program to help upsell and cross-sell Amazon products. So people like you and I, we are the customer, we use these services from Google and Apple and Amazon, and we feel they're pretty amazing. So we then expect the financial services, banks, insurance should be able to give us the exact same experiences. And that's actually helped drive change in FinTech and help grow FinTech as well. Because people bring experience from outside financial services into financial services. So that's another thing that that helps us to grow for FinTech. So PwC does a global survey every year because we have to keep track of what's going on in the world. So one of the surveys is FinTech Report, and this has just came out part of the press. You can go to the website and have a look at the full report. It's actually pretty good. There's some highlights positive situation, and these are CEO and head of strategy who are responsible for innovation and strategy. So I can only show you a couple of highlights given the time limitation. So this is one of the questions that we ask. So we ask these people, so what financial activities do you think that your customers are really using with FinTech? Right, so these are responses. Focus on the top three ones. Payment. People already use payment. Not going to bank, use Alipay, Apple Pay, social payment. So many formal applications to go to payment without going to the bank. Second, fund transfer. Who needs bank these days? Right? If I want to transfer the fund, I don't need a bank, I just pay up a phone, right? Throughout the application. And I can just send transfer money to you. So that's the bank in this picture. You don't need a bank, right? And then personal finance, you need a quick loan. You don't have to go to filling out application form, going through credit rating, which takes weeks and months. People can't wait this day. So again, go to FinTech, right? It's easier and quicker, and you still get the money. Maybe at even a cheaper rate. So just an example that people are actually using the services. They actually ignore the bank entirely. The second one, we then asked bank financial institute as well that for them to retain the customer, what do they think they have to do? So the answer broken down into payments, banking, insurance, asset and wealth management. So interestingly, the answers came out to be exactly the same. So they all say that to compete with FinTech, what they have to do is to make their services easier to use, easier, quicker, more innovative, right? Not surprising all of us. If they don't change or move quick enough, they will be losing, and they have been losing market share to FinTech companies already. And then we can ask, right? So because FinTech is backed up by technology, so we have big financial institutes. So over the next 12 months, what do you plan to do? What kind of technology do you want to invest in? And these are the answers. Top three. First, not surprised, data analytics. There's a lot of data these days. People have mobile phone. They don't use the phone for making phone calls. They use the phone for application. They generate data every single day. And with industry 4.0, Thailand 4.0, there's a lot of data, going to need even more data that generate to the world. So whoever can analyze the data, understand the behavior, get customer insight, move it, right? So that's why analytics will become a key part to every company. And that's a top priority that people will invest in. And second, mobile, right? I'm sure all of you have more than one mobile. I have three personally. So I can always be reachable, right? And mobile means they are smartphone, they're computer, they're supercomputer, right? You may ask when I ask this question, you look at the phone, right? How many percent that you use a phone for the phone feature, typical phone, making phone call and receiving phone call? 0.1%. We use it for 99% for application, for data, for social program, for work, for making appointment, use as a camera. So this is how wonderful the phone is these days. And it has been, that's why it has been used as a media to transact the business, to communicate with your client, to connect with your potential customer. So there are a lot more investment that we've seen that are going to mobile. And the third one, and this has become popular as well, artificial intelligence, which is a technology to simulate human beings. In fact, this actually has become quite real. I'm actually doing a proof of concept for my banking client in Thailand to use robots to replace human in certain applications. So there are a few projects we're looking to, like accounting processes or even loan approval process. You can actually use bots to replace some of the human being processing, which is quite cool, right? But they work 2-3 a.m. in the morning, but they will get tired, but will not play, but will not move, right? So actually that's quite attractive. And actually big companies are investing into this heavily. That becomes quite scary. Okay, so next there are a lot more questions that we ask clients, so feel free to check out the website for the full report. So FinTech ecosystem. This picture changes every day. This is the last one that I download. This is what ecosystem looks like, right? right? FinTech is such a broad term. If you look into the focus area for FinTech, the big one is lending. FinTech, focusing on providing, giving money to people. Lending Club is the biggest one. It started from a small company and it got listed at the stock exchange in the US. And Mac got so scared that they're afraid that they're going to Lending Club and take market share. And then trying to become a partner with Lending Club. And then personal finance, payment, remittance, and all other. There's so many groups, there's so many focuses that each of the company focus on. But these people, like I mentioned, change every day. Some will disappear because they won't make it. But some will, with a good funding and they continue to evolve themselves, they can become real and then become a financial services firm in the future. In Thailand, I think we have a number of fintech companies as well. I think the number, I don't have the latest number, but it's probably 200 by now. The top one, I'm sure you may know, Chitta, focusing on investment. Or claim the focusing on making claim quicker to insurance company and a few others. Please stay connected because the world changed very quickly these days, and this one become quite interesting to see how it evolved. So a few key one I want to mention. This is the top one called Prosper. It's startup that has become very popular. But what they do is they provide peer-to-peer lending platform. Meaning you need money, you don't need to go to a bank. You can just go to the application, put in a request. And then you can actually check out these the list of people who actually want to loan money. Right? So they are this system aggregate a platform. They match people who want to loan, people who want to lend money to other people. So they are and they act almost like a bank. They also have a process to check credit rating as well. So you don't just get money anymore you request, but there's a process to go through. So there is a process to check credit rating. But how do you do that? This is on the right-hand column. These are the process to check credit rating, right? For those who don't have good, record at credit bureau, they can apply to this application by going to a few questionnaire, fill out a questionnaire like what you would be using the money for, what's your monthly income, and what amount you want to go through. So, and then the application will assess your credit rating. So if you want to apply for a loan, use money for gambling, you might get 0 score. But if you want to apply for a loan to pay for a student loan, right, then you might get 10 score. So there's a process to go through. And behind this application, there's a robotic engine that assesses yourself and give you the rating. So quite interesting because the loan amount isn't big, right? And it's become quite popular. Some fintech applications offer a larger amount of loan, like $5,000 or but this one is a small one, but become pretty popular. Because when you need a quick cash, you don't want to borrow from your friends or parents, you can just go to the application. Another one that is quite interesting is RoboAdvisor. It's an investment website. Fully backed up by robotic application, meaning it's not human who will be talking to you on the website or advising you where to invest, how to invest, how much to invest. Behind the engine is artificial intelligence. It's smart enough, it's machine learning, so that she will learn from the historical record and be able to provide advice to you on where you want, where you should invest. So this application started off as a really small company and become quite popular because the fee amount is zero. If you want to invest, if you go to a bank, line, how much we have to pay? that's quite a significant amount. But fintech, like this one in particular, mostly investing $0. That's why it becomes unattractive. And it's not annoying as well because some investor sometimes can be quite annoying when they stick you on. And there are a lot more as well, like this one in particular focuses on cyber security. So in the future, right, security will improve. And this one, the one I like is because it uses behavior based to authenticate, to show who you are. Let me just explain for you. So let's say you have a phone, right? And I'm sure all of you set up a passport for the phone. If you don't, you should actually do so. Because that's one way to improve security. So if let's say I try to steal Dr. Kelly's passport, I can type it in and become her, right? So this logic will prevent that. Even if I have her passport, but I type it in with my pattern, I will not be able to log in because it was detect the pattern. That's why it's called behavior-based authentication. You need to have information, you need to have the exact same thing that's called behavior. Yeah, which is good. That's a good recommendation check often. But this one will actually say, if this analogy becomes alive in the future, it actually reduce the hacking or stolen of information. Because even if I have your passport, but I don't type with your pattern, right, then I can't log in. So another group of fintech that focus on cybersecurity. So there are a lot more. So within the reason we feel that things move fast as well. So we actually have our own platform to keep track of fintech, right? To see how many new companies, what services they're focusing on, how many get funding, what kind of funding, for us to actually stay up to date with technology, and we actually ask clients to sign up for this as well. And lastly, given the fast pace of technology, fintech is just one area. They are insurtech for insurance, utiltech for utility, regtech for regulator, like governtech, and a lot more small companies that are backed up by technology. So as an individual entrepreneur or business owner, what you should do? Well, a few recommendations. First, start to understand technology a bit more. There are so many emerging technology. I haven't even touched on drone yet, or AI, or I just need a day to go through that. But technology share, you will only get better, your life better, easier. So I think stay up to date, explore how it can help your business or in the future, your organization you'll be working for. Second, if you cannot compete with fintech or this technology company, what you should do? Well, partner with them. If you have money, you can buy them. Well, buy them, partner with them, join them, join with them. Or they find ways to work with them. Fintech can be a good thing for you. They have great idea, and they were able to actually convert idea into action pretty quickly, maybe quicker than you. Sometimes large organizations have too many bureaucratic and costly to go through. So if there are way to partner with fintech, I think that would be a great way. Integrate to innovate. Many companies do not innovate fast enough. They will no longer be in the business. If they are, they're very lucky. The business chain, technology chain, right? So organizations have to adjust and evolve and innovate. Create an IT culture. You don't have to be a deep IT expert. What you have to do is to understand how IT can help you and be able to help improve the customer experiences. And then I think last thing I want to touch on is company culture. Many clients that I work with would like to become digitized business, digital company, digital enterprises. So I should ask them, do you have a digital culture yet? It's not just about having money to invest in technology, you actually have to have digital culture. The culture that you are encouraging people to explore technology, try, experiment, and don't wake them up when they fail. Right? Because big corporates sometimes have that behavior, right? If anybody try, come up with new money and try and fail, then they will penalize. So that's not digital culture. Digital culture is you are encouraging people to bring idea to work, right? Try the idea. Give them the opportunity to convert their idea into action. Because people like Apple, Uber, these are from small organizations, they have good idea, they have digital culture to encourage people to convert into idea and then continue to evolve and then they become big organization. So I think for those who actually want to convert into digital organization, they must have the culture to allow that to happen. So foster company culture, allow talent to come out to shine, to try new things, and then become successful. Okay, so I think I have.
That fintech has played a very important role in the our lives, not just for the student's life, the business life. You know, when you go, when you graduate and you go into the your future career, you know, your jobs, you know, it's very interesting to see that how we adapt ourselves. You know, and this has become very important to us. I think we have quite a lot of questions, you know, to ask about the fintech, and I believe that will be very interesting questions as well. As you was talking about the Prosper, very interesting. We also have that in Thailand in the very old version we call, we play Dolce. And then we play